Here he is, Gabriel Iglesias. Fluffy has returned triumphant from all these different things. The Narcos thing was so good.
I know that caught everybody off guard, right?
Totally. I'm like, wait, is that him? And where did he get that big gun? Was that fun?
Yeah, it was. Getting to play a bad guy was really, really cool. Getting to get, you know, shot up was actually, you know, and I grew up in L.A.
Right.
So to to have that happen and I'm still here, it's great.
Fair enough. Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. And then we're going to talk more about Coco when the movie comes up, but the Pixar movie, you're in that as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I get shot up. I do Disney, whatever.
What kind of, are you an animal in Coco, or where are you?
I play a social worker in the movie Coco.
Okay.
Which is pretty cool. You know? I don't really have a name. I'm just social worker.
There. Okay. Exactly. Let me ask you this question. You posted on Facebook a while back that Fluffy was fine, but Gabriel needed some help. What was that about?
Oh, earlier this year, man. It's just, you know, this is my 20th year now doing stand-up. And, you know, with time, you do something long enough, you don't take a break. I never took any breaks. Right. I mean, it's 20 years of constantly grinding, grinding, grinding. I'm on the road 46, 47 weeks out of the year, and it just caught up to me. Mm. And so I took 2 months off, regrouped, and now I'm back on the road.
All right, talk to us about the way you felt before that 2 months and the way you felt after that 2 months.
Before the 2 months, like, the world was coming in on me. Like, the pressure, just everything. I mean, you know, you got to figure the amount of touring that I was doing, plus a personal life, plus just, you know, doing voiceover animated, doing acting. I mean, there was a combination of different things. We were doing the show with those. I mean, there was so many things going on. And, it was just too much. I needed to, you know, start...
And I think it's often very difficult for people to unplug. Was that like, did somebody tell you, hey, you should do this?
Or No, my body told me. My body said, dude, what are you doing? It was a lot. And, you know, trying to control my diabetes as well.
Right.
So it was like a combination of all these different things. And, you know, people don't see that. It's one of those I had to actually walk away and they go, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I think I'll be all right.
Mm. All right, then 2 months pass. Mm-hmm. And then what made you feel, all right, I am okay?
I got rid of a lot of the stuff that I was doing. Mm-hmm.
And just in terms of your behaviors or what?
Well, no, as far as like just, you know, by taking on so much.
Right.
When you take on all this stuff, the problem with success sometimes is that learning how to say no is really, really hard because you never know when this is going to go away.
Right.
You work so hard to get to a certain point and then it's one of those things where you don't want to break the momentum.
Right.
Yeah. You know, and basically it was at the peak. It's at the 20-year mark and all of a sudden, you know, the machine stopped working right.
Well, I think the difficult thing is, you know, my guess is you are well rewarded for the things that you do, but you remember the times when you weren't. And so, this offer, it's hard to say it's impossible.
I call it the beach ball. You always want to keep that beach ball up in the air. You
right.
know, show business, you never know. You're here one day, gone the next. So you need to capitalize while you can.
But, okay, now given this track record, this success, you know the relationship you have with fans.
Mm-hmm.
Do you still feel that way?
You know what? I never want to get comfortable. When you get comfortable, that's when, you know, that's when things happen. You get sloppy. So I just want to make sure that I'm constantly working and constantly keeping myself out there and remember that this can go away. And as long as you keep that frame of mind, you know, you're going to be all right.
And then doing all the tour dating, we're going to talk about a local date here in just a second. What do you do to refresh the comedy? Or is that just all in your head? And you?
Oh, all the drama that I've been dealing with.
Right.
Oh, trust me, the new show is awesome. That's one great thing that comes from, you know, having all kinds of different experiences is that it's constantly refreshing the act.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Tell us about the Fluffy Fee-Free Prison.
You can't say it, can you?
Yeah.
You can't
well,
say it.
Well, it's like saying Calvillo and Camarillo or whatever.
Yeah. Right.
I can the Fluffy, what is it? I can say it if I read it.
Okay.
It's the Fluffy's Fee-Free Presale. Basically, I'm going to be at the Staples Center tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. And anybody who buys tickets to my upcoming Staples Center event, I'll be there to sign tickets, take pictures.
Oh, that's great.
And
you're doing nice. Are you shooting it for Netflix or anybody?
No, Netflix will be there.
Oh, okay.
Keep an eye. Oh. Yeah. No, I'll be there all day until they stop selling tickets.
And then, by the way, if you've ever gone to LA Live, there's a particular parking lot where next to the Electric Spaces, you have your own space. Which I think is the
you
coolest
do?
Thing.
You do?
Yeah.
I call it the Ghetto Walk of Fame. You know, it's one of those, it's not in the, it's in the parking lot,
right.
You know, but it's a big
parking space. Yeah, but that's even better.
That's better.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, and they basically, it has my name on it. It's reserved. Got the reserved for. And.
But do you ever show up and somebody's in your spot?
It's happened twice.
Oh.
So what do you do?
Well, I don't want to report. I don't want to get somebody towed.
Right. Yeah.
But I will tell the staff, like, hey, well, you guys give me a parking, but you let people park in it.
All right, let me read this whole thing. Fluffy kicks off the 2018 World Tour called One Show Fits All. It's January 28th at Staples Center. Tickets on sale to the public, as we mentioned, November 10th, AXS.com. Pre-sale, live in person at Staples Box Office with Fluffy himself on the 8th. And guess what? He does not come alone. We're giving away pair of tickets to the show, text the word stand up to 515151. You get two tickets to see the show. You have until noon to enter. Good luck. You know what? I say this for all of us. It is great to see you.
It really
Thank
is.
Thank you. Yeah.
Good to have you back.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Gabriel.